God's commands to parents. And these words that I command you today shall be on your heart. You shall teach them diligently to your children, and shall talk of them when you sit in your house, and when you walk by the way, and when you lie down, and when you rise. You shall bind them as a sign on your hand, and they shall be as frontlets between your eyes. You shall write them on the doorposts of your house, and on your gates. Deuteronomy 6:6-9. In 40 years of teaching inner-city preschool and elementary-age summer camp, I have never known these methods to fail. I have never found a better way to connect children to God's Word. God's methods are to be trusted. Personally, I start in the middle with when you lie down and when you rise up, because it is so simple for even the busiest parent to buy a little flip-over calendar with a verse a day. Put a calendar by your child's bed and help him or her remember to flip it each morning or night. Flipping the calendar at night might actually affect a child's dreams and give him a good start to the next day. God seems to have noted right off that the two times a day we, children, are most teachable are in the morning and at night. Then I usually move to the verse about putting God's Word on your gates and doorposts, putting God's Word on display in the home, giving your home a Bible makeover. Being surrounded by Bible verses partly makes up for all the time something else seems important. It's almost like God knew both parents and children's number one need would be reminders. Like He knew we would need to surround ourselves with His Word in plain sight. Parents who can't afford to purchase framed Christian art or do not have a Christian gift shop nearby can download free coloring pages at www.bibleparent.com. Two of their pages are unique. The sun catchers, for taping in a window, a reminder that God's light enters the home through His Word, and mirror pages, which must be held up to a mirror to read, just as we must hold them up to God for our heart to understand. Coloring with our children is also a perfect time to talk to God's Word when you sit in your house. The third command is to tie God's Word to our hands and foreheads. And I personally still wear a little silver case around my neck with my life verse in it. But I am sure God would accept Bible verses in our pockets. The idea is to carry them with us as a reminder that God goes where His Word goes. Other reasons kids should carry a Bible verse with them: because it gives the Holy Spirit a chance to influence the child before his friends do. Because most 5 to 12-year-olds will not look up a verse on their own, even if they do carry a phone. Because it is a clear witness to our children that Holy Scripture is important to us, and that it is not just for Sunday. Because the child will remember all his life the feel of having a verse in his or her pocket. As a Jewish child, Jesus doubtless had his own verses with him at all times. The command no one wants to hear is the verse with the word diligently in it. It's almost like God knew we would tend to let things slide. Like He knew that after 4 or 5 years and 1 or 2 children, no parent is likely to be diligent at anything. Which brings us to an interesting fact. If you notice, the opening verses on this article begin with the word and. And what comes before the and is the greatest commandment. Love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your strength. And God's commands to parents are actually the second half of the greatest commandment. Would God lie to us, or could sharing daily scriptures with our children matter so much to us, to Him, and to them? Obey God's commands. Give your home a Bible makeover, the little scripture calendar to put by their beds, the coloring pages to put His Word on display in our homes, the pocket scriptures to remind our children that God goes where His Word goes, that He wants to be real to them 7 days a week. Charles White is a retired preschool teacher and has spent 40 years building www.bibleparent.com, a website with all the tools your church needs to equip parents to be the spiritual leaders their children need. Thousands of bedside flipovers, coloring pages, and pocket scriptures. He asks prayer that our nation's denominational leaders return to printing Bible promise cards, once the heart and soul of childhood in the church. www.BibleParent.com. BibleParent.com.